Hey guys, what is going on? It's Austin here, and today I got a video for you, and we are talking about the top 5 superhero games on the PlayStation 5. But before I get into it, I just want to say, since the PS5 did just come out, this list isn't 100% games only on PS5. It includes PS5 releases and the inclusion of backwards compatible titles that were released on the PS4 that can be played on PS5. Alright, without further ado, let's get right into it. For our number 5 spot, kicking off the list, we have Batman Arkham Knight. Arkham Knight is by far the biggest Arkham game to date, but bigger is not always better. But although Arkham Knight is a little bit more of a controversial game, if you can look past a few glaring hiccups, the PS5 will be the best place to experience Gotham City, with 4K 60 frames per second support, but that's only if your TV or monitor supports it. Arkham Knight does have its fair share of critics, but for me it is one of my all-time superhero games, and it's at least worth a try. For our number 4 spot, we have Infamous Second Son. Yes, we have a lesser-known hero game on the list, but don't let that fool you into thinking it's a lesser experience. Infamous Second Son features one of the most realistic and breathtaking renditions of Seattle, while supplying the player with 3 different superpowers to traverse the rainy streets. Running at the speed of light with the neon power, dashing through the vents to the top of the building with the smoke power, or flying through the city with the video power. Infamous Second Son is a blast, beginning to end, and even features multiple endings depending on which karmic state you played as, either a villain or a hero, the choice is up to you. Now for our number 3 spot, we have Spider-Man Miles Morales. To no surprise at all, Miles Morales makes the list, and it is at an impressive 3rd place. And it was very close deciding if this should overtake the next entry, but with close consideration, we decided 3rd place was best for Miles. Spider-Man Miles Morales takes everything that was great about Marvel Spider-Man and builds upon it. But Spider-Man Miles Morales can't help but feel like a glorified expansion for the original Marvel Spider-Man. It is another great step in the right direction for Marvel's game development, but overall wasn't as much of a change for us to put it higher on the list. Keeping the Spider-Man theme, for our number 2 spot, we have Spider-Man Remastered. Now, I don't need to get into why Marvel Spider-Man is a great game. If you're watching this video, chances are you already know that or you've already played the game. But Spider-Man Remastered preserves the award-winning story and addicting gameplay while also offering new content in the form of suits and giving New York City a graphics update with the support of ray tracing. But I still can't get over the new face of Peter. Before we get to our number 1 spot, I just want to list our honorable mentions. We have Deadpool, which is a game you can't buy digitally on the PS4. This is a huge disclaimer. Deadpool is a great game. It's definitely a little more cheaply made, but it captures the essence of Deadpool perfectly. But the only way to get your hands on a copy is a physical game copy, because the license expired on the PlayStation Store and you can no longer buy it digital. So if you're interested in Deadpool, you're gonna have to check Amazon, eBay, GameStop, or any other games retail store. Our other honorable mention is Arkham Asylum. Now, there's no real reason I didn't put it on the list other than I can't have my top 5 being every single Arkham game. Trust me, it definitely could have. But much like Marvel Spider-Man, you don't need to hear me talk about how great Arkham Asylum is, and if you do, you can check out my Arkham Asylum retrospective in the top right. Coming in at our number 1 spot, we have Marvel's Avengers. For our number 1 spot, we have Batman Arkham City. The king of superhero games continues to reign supreme. Arkham City's masterfully crafted storyline and obsessive free-flow combat continues to keep gamers engaged years after release and remaster. Additionally, the Return to Arkham collection that you would have to play on PS5 features all added DLC, including every single Batsuit released to the game, and the story expansion Harley Quinn's Revenge. Arkham City is another game where you just play through that story and you just come back to it every so often, every few months, every few years, and you relive it, and it is just as good as you remember. But this is just my list. It is not the right list. It's just my opinion. If you guys have a different top 5, or if it's mostly similar and there's a few differences, comment them down below. I like to see what games you guys are playing and what games you think are better than mine. And I would also like to hear why it would be better or worse than my list. I love interacting with you guys and hearing what's going on with you. If you want to see gameplay from either of these games, I have gameplay from most of them. I have a Deadpool walkthrough currently going on. You can see that in the top right or in the description down below. And I also did an Arkham City walkthrough a few years ago. If you want to check that game out, make sure to check that also in the top right and the bottom description. Anyway, that's it for me, guys. Have a wonderful day and peace out.